Alrighty, let's get into this mess here. First, let's turn this off, because old destroyed 45s somehow don't seem so bad on some of the cheaper equipment. Speaking of cheap equipment, boy, have we got some cheapness here today, but it was pretty interesting. First, we'll see the caution here. This is an electrical toy. As with all electrical products, precautions should be observed during handling and use to prevent electric shock. I think that's a November 70 date code on the bottom of this box. Greater New York Box Company. And what do we have here? Looky here. I think that this box was originally printed for something else. Vanity Fair, maybe? Who knows? But Party Time. Tele-Tone Phonograph. And I love the 50s children's storybook illustrations surrounding this beatnik hippie looking record player here. Model 132 two-speed acoustical phonograph, 45 and 78, fine mechanical producer head, engineered for the engine, designed and engineered for the child. Okay. So, of course, this is the original box, model 132. What does this say? Defective arm to hen? Defective arm. Powers on, does not spin. Defective arm. So that probably explains why this thing is practically untouched. It was probably bought new and returned to where it was purchased, because it didn't work. Got shoved back in a box. Never sent back for a warranty return. And here it is today. So these Kiddie phonographs really wore out pretty quick cosmetically, because these were just cardboard cases with a kind of a, I don't even think this is vinyl, I think it's paper, the coating. This one obviously has been socked away for many years because it was defective. And I'm really not, I mean, that little GE over there is about the extent of this Kiddie phonograph as I usually get. But this one was just in too nice a shape and kind of too much of a trip not to bring it here. So it's a Kiddie Agogo. Kiddie Agogo Living Phono by Tele-Tone. Yes, indeed. And like I said, being this box was made in November 70, you know, that's the oldest that this thing could be. And we have our plastic platter with the little rubber stuff on it. Typical power switch. Two-speed. 45 and 78. Still no 33. Well, I guess this would not have... done good to play a 33 needle. Little contact probably from the cord up there when it was originally stored. Play, rest. So this pivots up. So this is all plastic. We have one little, like a punch, like it was punched out there. It's interesting. Not all of the grills were punched out. It doesn't even come in contact with anything. One thing you often see on these, whether they're acoustical or with a regular tone arm, You usually see a big scratch line in the cardboard across here because of course, the kids dragging it along. So, have not plugged this in. Let me pause this and get it plugged in. All right, plugged in, turns on, does not spin. Well, it's spinning now, isn't it? Let's find one of our, in fact, here's one here. This one will not trigger a copyright. Seagull Brothers and Naomi, Songs of Faith. Well, we got another problem. We got no needle in here. We had some needle scotch tape to the operating instructions. This information is important in order for you to receive maximum pleasure from your phonograph. Please read carefully. Standard play is 78, large center hole is 45. And we got this little diagram here. Needles should be changed often to produce clearest possible sound. And we have warranted for 90 days exclusive of needles. Replacement parts. Most commonly required parts for your phonograph. Please enclose your check. Include 50 cents to cover handling and postage. We cannot ship cash on delivery. Do you know that cash on delivery, COD, is still a service offered by the Postal Service? I can't even remember the last time I've seen anything shipped COD. I did have something postage due a couple of years ago because they didn't put enough postage on the letter. And the mail lady actually wanted 52 cents from my wife to take the letter, which is crazy. But anyhow, here is the parts list for one of these. 10 packages of needles, 5 per package, 50 needles for $1. Wow. Well, anyhow, let me get a needle in here. Ooh. And, let's see what we can do. So these are Duotone filter point. It says on the back here, lower record wear, filter scratch. Ooh, filters to scratches, high fidelity. Made by new process, place 12 to 15 records, points will not break. All right, so there were two needles in that package. And we'll go with that. And we've got it installed down here. And here we go. Catastrophic failure. Well, you could already see what the needle was doing to this record here. And I don't think that's polystyrene, but who knows. Okay, there it's running. Ooh. Okay, there it's running. Yeah, we better just open this up and see what's going on here. Thankfully, I think I can get this off without breaking its adapt. Well, it seems like the motor just needs a good oiling. I'm not sure how to get the case on one of these apart. This motor board does not seem to want to come out easily, even though it doesn't seem like there's a hell of a lot holding it together. I think it's just pressed in here, but I'm not sure, and I'm going to consult with an expert before I attempt that. That would be Radio TV Phono Nut. He's been in a bunch of these type of things. Part of the problem, you can see how loose this is. Now, can't do anything about the rivets here, but you can see these nuts are loose. So I think we need to tighten these up. If we can, may not be able to. I'm spinning these by hand, and well, hell, the whole screw's spinning with it. So unless I can get underneath here, I can't tighten this up. And you see, that screw's totally falling back. Who knows where the nut is? Probably rolling around inside of there somewhere. So I'm going to see if I can't get it run long enough. I put a drop of oil down the top there. Whatever good that may do. I'm going to see if I can't get at least one record to play. Find a record that's kind of maybe a lost cause anyhow. So there, we got it in 78. Where do I have those? Hang on. Alright, this may give us a copyright strike. I don't know. I don't know if it'll focus on here. Japanese MGM Silvana Mangano. This was a warped record that I got flattened. And excuse me. It's not a big deal either way. I think this thing is running a little slow, but let's see what happens. To this video after I'll figure out how to get to everything, get tight oiled and tightened up. And I don't know what's defective with the arm. Just a crappy piece of plastic that flops around in there. Don't know. Alright, so I got her re-oiled up and back together, and the motor secure, and all of that is taken care of. And here's a little demonstration. It's quite over-modulated. I don't know if there's anything I can do about that. I know they have quieter needles, but I mean, this is,
oh, they tell me you're from a home far beyond the sky. Oh, they tell me of a land far away. Oh, they tell me of a
Now that's not how it really sounds, even though it looks like it's eating the grooves a bit on this record. I mean, on another machine. So, same thing with this. You know what? For giggles, we'll try the other needle. Alright, I put the other needle on. These may be used, I don't know. It is putting a line in the record like the other one. Now, one thing I noticed is that it does not line up straight with the groove, that's for sure. It's a little angle. There's no real way to... There we are. It kind of is what it is. In fact, this already looks like it's tilted in anyhow. It's being square with the arm, it's cocked off to the left. I guess there's really no... So there it is, the 1970 Tele-Tone Kiddie Agogo model 132, and somebody on Facebook pointed out that I think it was under the Allegro label, which was a product of Pickwick, that they actually had a Kiddie Agogo album spelled the same way with the same picture, and it was I guess hip covers of nursery rhymes or something. I don't have that one, but there we go. Kiddie Agogo, and it's gonna agogo up on the shelf or something, because yeah, I don't have any experience with these acoustical jobs, but which, yeah, I mean, it's pretty distorted. All right, until next time.